and welcome to another episode of our special series, Beating All Odds. COVID-19 has thrown many challenges at us. It's been 8 weeks since we went into a complete lockdown. In these circumstances, we are all banking on leaders who, despite so many odds and challenges, are standing tall and ensuring that the business stays on track. With me today is one such leader, Ms. Neena Das Gupta, CEO and Director of Zirka Digital Solutions and CEO Adam's Ventures. I hope I got Adam correct. Welcome to the show.
Yes, you did.
Welcome to the show, Neena.
Thank you so much.
I must first congratulate you for your another venture. Now you are handling two companies. I really don't know how do you handle so much.
Well, you have the same number of hours. You just bring in efficiency, I guess. Circumstances make you more efficient. So I am managing well. One has to wait and see where it lands.
We're very confident that you're going to take it to another new level. So, you know, I was going through the list of your partners and your clients. So work with a lot of smaller networks. I mean, smaller in the sense, in sense of size, you know, be it Dangal or a lot of regional channels. All the broadcasters have been affected very badly because of the current crisis. AdEx has dropped by almost 70-80%. What kind of solutions or what kind of ways, what are you suggesting to them right now?
Okay, it's interesting. So just a little correction. I think something that needs to be corrected even on our website. Dangal has now set up their own team. We kind of, you know, took the business to a very new scale and height and advised them to set up their own team because it was wiser for them to do so. But we handle about 13 channels now, a lot of them in the south and east clusters, more regional channels. It's extremely interesting. The performance of television has actually improved, especially for news and GEC. Of course, you're constrained at home, you're sitting at home, you're spending a lot of time watching TV. And it's coinciding. Imagine every salesperson looks for these numbers. At the same time, this rise in number is coinciding with an absolute drop in advertising from brands. So what we have done is, we've started integrating packages. So I'm bringing in conversations of broadcast and digital bundled in together, where you start experiencing on television, end your experience on digital, or where you start experiencing on digital and end your experience on broadcast. So integration is adding engagement now to a television conversation. That's something new we are doing. We are also working on packages that are actually targeted at people viewing that channel, but outside of India. So we are making more efficient use of non-prime time bands and bringing in more revenue. Our innovation has been around packaging and programming significantly. My advice has been to package under specific heads because old has become new. So if you're packaging under famous old heroes, you're packaging under strong women roles, you're packaging music together because you can't create new content. So we are creating packaging. We are also speaking to some partners to bring gaming on, if that's a possibility. There are technologies today available. So we have been doing different things. The good part is that we've started seeing an uptake on the revenue. The exciting part is that when we emerge out of the lockdown and come back to more normal times or better times, I'm assuming that the revenue growth will actually grow significantly with the new initiatives. So that's how we are managing our broadcast. Even our digital partners, it's all innovation and evolution. So even for our digital partners, we are doing all innovations. We are actually mixing display, reach, video, programmatic, native, all of it. And we are focused on business outcome packages. So even for our digital partners, it's innovation is the key word for us.
So at Zirka, you have clients which are from hospitality sector. You also have clients from automobile. You have clients from, you've clients like Make My Trip. These are the clients who've seen a complete shutdown. You know, nobody is going on Make My Trip these days. What kind of recovery plans are you making for them?
So, see, these are partners who keep coming to us basis solutions we provide for them. And it's your recovery for tourism is going to be slow. and it's going to be very in different varied stages of emerging from lockdown. And I think the first thing will happen is building trust with the brand. Your travel will reduce out of fear, actually, more than anything else. You know, also out of a sense of reducing spendings and unnecessary spendings, right? So some people will want to save. Some people will be dominated by fear. And I think it's about time that it's at that time that the brand will start need to build trust, will need to assure people of how safe it is to travel. So for travel, I can tell you it's going to take time. However, at the same time, state tourism boards or our own government, Ministry of Tourism, they will have to move faster, because the income of the state or the income of the country, a significant amount of that comes from tourism. Once government itself starts building confidence, rebuilding the opportunity, all our partners like Make My Trip, all the hotels and hospitality industries will start seeing an uptake and benefit. So it's I don't believe it's something that's going to happen in the short term. I believe they're going to take probably a good amount of 12 months to 18 months to recover. They'll have to pivot. Some of their business pivoting will happen. They'll have to get into some new ideas of travel. They'll have to do new things. And I'm waiting to see what those could be.
Which are other sectors that you have noticed which are doing better or which have an opportunity right now? You know, a lot of digital consumption has gone up. So you have clients in OTT sector, or I'm sure you have a lot of other digital clients. What kind of advice are you giving to those partners?
See, we work across partners and across brands, right? For economists, I work with corporates and I work with government a lot. They are trying to address global audiences. So you have to understand the impact for many. Many companies are stable. Whether you look at a Microsoft, whether you look at many businesses, they are largely stable because their consumption and the need of the business continues to remain. For many industries, the gap is just the lockdown and the time period. So we are going clearly behind stable industries, one that are just waiting for the lockdown to emerge for them to get back into the same realm of business. Could be manufacturing, could be instruments and tools that are getting exported, right? So export is a very, very big part, even building that part. OTT, while OTT is interesting, one will have to wait and watch what happens with the movement of OTT. There is a spike now. One has to see where it comes and plateaus and settles down. So we work with OTT, but with OTT, our advice has been that get into something more steady and increase reach. It's about saying, how do you start making sure that your reach is far easier for your campaign than just a pure ad? There are sectors like government, there are sectors like IT that will very quickly transform, because digital transformation is required right now. So the opportunity, whether it's in Europe, whether it's in US, whether it's in Asia Pacific, opportunity for Indian clients is significant today, whether it's Wipro, Infosys, TCS, Tech Mahindra, all of them. So that's another sector that we're working on very closely. Our formats that we believe will succeed and work is very research heavy and is very content heavy. And the other part that will work, format that will work very significantly, is the social part, is your Instagram, your new formats of stories, how you're taking stories into publisher side, your feeds, just your expansion. It will no longer just be an Instagram. It will become a mode of communication, like there'll be a TV channel in Instagram. So those things, those are the innovations that we're working on for some of the stable sectors, and like food. These are stable sectors of food, but there is a new interest. So we are working on those mediums and those categories.
What are the overall challenges you think, you've spent almost more than two decades in this industry. What are the overall challenges that the entire industry is facing right now, and what kind of solutions would you suggest?
I think we need to reskill our sales team significantly. One thing that hasn't changed much is selling skill hasn't evolved. You know, a solution-based selling skill is there's a massive gap in the industry, and that shows with the way media is getting treated today. It is extremely commoditized. There is no value benefit analysis that is being discussed today. So I firmly feel that we need to actually reskill ourselves as far as sales goes, as far as, you know, building, engaging prospects goes. The other part is, I believe it's time that
what do you exactly mean when you say we need to reskill our sales team?
Is reskilling, typically we'll have to move from a format of just giving a solution because you have that as a product, your product solution, but actually shifting your view to saying, what is the brand want to do? How does the brand's consumer think? Who is the consumer for the brand? What does the consumer want? What is the consumer's patterns of media consumption? What is it that I have, and how can we then help together? I think we don't really go down to the level of understanding the brand's need in relation to the consumer. And not enough
of that. This is only on selling the product that we have.
You're just going and selling an inventory. You're just going and selling CPRP. You're just going and selling a unit. You know, it's like selling a liter of milk. But that needs to evolve, because I believe media does so much more. Collectively, it gives so much more back to the brand. It gives so much to consumer. A consumer also receives so much from consuming media totally. And I think we need to put the value of the consumer, the value of the brand in relation to the consumer, and the value to the media. So it needs to be unified. Training needs to actually happen basis that. How do you upskill to start talking more solutions? How do you use a lot of secondary research actually to do your sales? Your commoditized sale will continue, but it's not going to take you far. Only a few will survive. So I believe reskilling is required, meaning I'm reskilling myself. I've been a salesperson largely, right? I reskill myself. In fact, we're trying to talk to a lot of publishers, and we're telling them we'll help them as well, because I've done that with a lot of my team. So we'll help them as well to reskill. The other part also, which is extremely needed, is we need to actually start using a lot of research again, offline research, the good old offline research, which understands the consumer personas and understands mindsets. Everything online is good, but there is significant merit in offline research. It somehow adds so much more merit to what one is doing. So these are two things that I totally believe must be brought back. In my journey of last two decades, I these two are the ones that stand out really, really strongly for me. And I, of course, think that all of us need to learn from the youth of today. You know, the methods of working have changed, as we are seeing now.
See, working from home is very challenging, and it's also something new for many of us. We have not done it in the past. What kind of day-to-day problems are you facing as a professional while working at home, from home?
Oh, man. As a professional, I'm facing a bad hair day problem. Literally, right? I think we are filling in too much of our time with calls. There is very little time for thought. Decision making is delayed. Decisions are not getting taken as faster as they used to. Some parts are good. You're saving a lot of time by not being stuck on the road and doing something more meaningful. But I'm still trying to figure whether that's good or bad, because you're also kind of filling in a lot of space. While you were traveling, you were quiet, you were thinking, you were catching up on your calls with clients. You're actually not able to do that much any longer. You're doing much more, but far less.
The productivity is reduced?
Well, we are yet to see. Productivity, of course, is by default impacted. Outputs are impacted given the current scenario. But I would guess if one was to put a barometer, for some it has gone up, for some it has gone down. For our research team, productivity has gone through the roof. You know, they're one after the other taking out brilliant pieces of research. For my product team, it's improved. But for my marketing and sales team, Well, you know what? We're not used to sitting at home always.
Yeah.
So there, your productivity will by default reduce. One is market conditions. Two is your own frustration. And we are constantly trying to keep our people motivated. We're telling them accept the frustration if there is. We do two days a week gaming.
That was my next question.
Okay, so then before you could ask the question.
How are you keeping your entire team motivated in these crises?
So we do it in bits and pieces, okay? There is one thing we do. So me and my executive management team, about four of them, we talk every evening. That's the safe place where we kind of, you know, share our frustrations, issues. It's a very friendly chat. We laugh. We talk. That's how we take care of each other first at the top level, which is what Karan and I do regularly. And for the rest of the people, we have created these zones of safety completely. So there are gaming. So each day, there are groups created. Each day, every group has to spend some amount of time on an activity, on the next activity that is being planned for the week. So there are two activities for the week. So you're making sure that other than work, they're doing something which is saying, how do I take an entire gaming thing outside of my office? You know, how do we bring really 13 people from some 18 cities together now. Actually, not 13, 18 cities. We think of how do we get external people who are posting games into our office? How do we do music? So we are also trying to figure how you play music one after the other when so many people are doing. Next week, there is one guy who's doing origami for the children of Zarka. You know, so all the kids will come in. So every day, every group is spending about an hour planning on different activities. And twice a week, we have about 2 hours of each time, 2 hours of some gaming. There is something always on cinema and there's something always on art and story. And the other thing we just do is we talk to them and we just say, well, accept it. Yeah, this is how it is as of now. And it's not going to be like this forever. So that's all we are doing to try and keep them motivated, engaged, actually, more than anything, engaged. You know, and empathy.
Before we close, I would want you to speak for a few minutes, you know, some piece of advice, some suggestions you have for those who just started their digital venture this year, just before the lockdown. There are too many startups that came in last few weeks or few months or a few years. And right now the market is really in that state. A lot of people have been affected. What kind of motivation or advice or suggestion would you want to give to them?
Okay. So one is, it's very easy to get disheartened. You know, if you do get disheartened, live with that emotion for a very short while, but then just get out of it because it's not going to serve any purpose. It's not easy. Remember, it's not never easy to do a startup. It's never easy to run your own business. But it is that much more satisfying. So connect to the satisfaction, less to the place of, you know, being demotivated. Two is actually connect with a few people who have been in the space and actually make a group. Tell them that you're trying to make this group at a time when you wanted to hit the road running, but you've kind of come to a horrible stop. And these are people who can probably advise you, will not judge you because they've gone through the same phase themselves. There is nothing called failing. There is only a bad day or a good day. So there's someone to hold your hand during a bad day. And the third is become a member of a body. And at this time, you can go and maybe if you're in the digital space, go to, IMAI probably at this time, or if you're in the mobile space, MMA, become a member of the body, ask them to give you a massive discount, but a body supports you so much. That's where you can ask for help, for support in small things like marketing, in small things like tools that you're not able to use yourselves. You know, the community gets in and helps you. So don't hesitate to ask for help. And at this point, focus on your business. Don't focus on your own, your own success or your own failure. It is about the success of the business and what do you need to do, and what do you need your team members to do to succeed. So act on that. Yeah. So that's it from my side. Only those three pieces.
That is really inspiring. Even I'm feeling inspired right now because I also Lovely. Needed some kind of motivation. Thank you so much, Nina, for speaking to us. It's always a pleasure talking to you. And stay at home and stay safe. We wish you and your entire family, your office, everyone good health. And let's hope this pandemic ends as soon as possible. Thank you so much for speaking to us.
Thank you so much. You take care as well. Bye-bye.